events over the last 5 years. Now, I began my journey as a startup junkie 4 years ago. I'm heading to my first startup weekend with a little bit of trepidation. I had absolutely no idea what I was getting myself into. And I wasn't really sure if I would fit in. I'm too old for this. I'm not a techie, and I'm a girl. And what I learned is that startup junkies come in all shapes and sizes. From the very youngest startup junkie I met, he was 17 years old, drove over from Ohio, and this kid had amazing programming skills, to the 70-year-old retiree who came looking for his life's next great invention. Every startup weekend is filled with programmers and developers, graphic designers, user interface people. But we also have that share of business and development people, marketing people, accountants, lawyers, corporate people who are not quite sure why they're there, would-be entrepreneurs, and people who are looking for their next job. And what they share is a common interest in starting a business and seeing if they can do it in 54 hours. And the other thing that this group of people shares is a certain level of comfort with chaos. Because Startup Weekend is a no-rules environment, and you know it right from the minute that it starts. You know that as you listen to the pitches, and sometimes someone gets up and pitches an idea, and you know they have carried that idea around with them for a very long time. And they're hoping that this is the room that will contain someone who can actually help them turn that idea into a reality. Other ideas, you can tell that they thought about it in the car on their way over. Regardless of how the idea is created, they are all evaluated the same way. Is this something we can build in a weekend? Is this something that has a market underneath it? And is this something that's going to be fun to work on? Ultimately, we don't assign people to their teams. They vote with their feet. They decide which team they can make the greatest contribution with. And they form their teams and they start working somewhere around 9:30 on Friday night. And there's this amazing transformation that occurs between 9:30 and midnight. Because somewhere in that 2.5 hours, this group of strangers become united around an idea, a concept, and a business. They begin assigning roles and responsibilities and divvying up the workload. And as they're leaving at the end of Friday night, you know they are a team. And we always tell them to get a good night's sleep because Saturday is a really long day. Saturday, we typically run from about 9 o'clock in the morning to well past midnight. And in that day, you have an opportunity to experience everything that will occur in the first year of startup. Andrew Hyde, the original founder of Startup Weekend, once told me that you will live a year of your life in this 54 hours, and every hour is a week, and believe me, it feels that way. As you discuss your ideas, develop your ideas, and suddenly, somewhere around 2:30 in the afternoon, is that pivot moment, when you realize that what you thought your business was going to be about won't work, whether it's a failure in technology or whether it's a change in the market. And the successful teams, just like in real life, the successful businesses pivot. And so what you see on Sunday night is often dramatically different from what was pitched on Friday. And really, developing that community. Walk through a Verge event. Walk through a room like this and talk to people who are starting businesses. And you will see that we are building a community. The long-term economic viability of Indiana does not rest with the next Toyota plant or the next Honda. It will be built on the work, the creativity, and the talent of the community that we're building. If you're not doing anything on the weekend of the 17th, come join us in Indiana or in Bloomington. Up in Lafayette, they moved their weekend to January. Come for Friday night and hear the pitches and stay for the weekend and find out how we're building a new community.